cui îl pun lui de să facă de vinții la tuturor și de atenți, ala de complainant, o intending to withdraw the entire complaint. And as such, that there was a family meeting that took place between the complainant and the accused person, convened by their uncles, and they had made advanced steps to resolve this issue, the family dispute essentially. And that his instructions were for the plea to be deferred to a later date. In fact, in his words, he thought indefinitely. And we do hope that the family will resolve the matter. So on the strength of Mr. Kach's representation, I told him, when brothers want to agree, I can't be the one to insist they must fight in court. I was accommodative of that suggestion. I didn't think that had been sorted until I've just had my colleague talk about that now in court.
With your kind permission, Your Honor, Mr. Kach forwarded the file to Professor Jakoya's office on 8 December 2020. So as at now, he currently doesn't have instructions for this file. And our instructions, according to our client, are that you are coming for the key taking of the matter. Yes, password to a meeting. The file was forwarded to Professor Jakoya with full instructions.
Your Honor, my name is Ikua. This is indeed our letter. In these two matters. Eh? But we did
forward brief for Mr. Kach in this matter.
Yes, and in 1097 as well. Yes. But as counsel has indicated, this matter has since been taken over by Professor Jakoya, so they have substantive instructions.
Whether you're keeping the prosecutor in the know, because I think now I get to a point when I really have to define the role of a lawyer watching for you. Because it doesn't, Mr. Willis, everything to this trial to be seamless, in as much as the victim has a right to legal representation or their views to be heard by the court, I think the role of lawyers working with also needs to be very, very clear so that we do not have to seem to be working. I don't see in the court seem to, the matter to be prosecuted, doesn't seem to be prosecuted by the lawyer working with. I don't know whether my prosecutor is in the mood. All this back and forth.
No, I've just heard from my colleague here, who's not aware of this. I've spoken to him, who's not aware of any such deliberation.
Yes. In the effect of, in light of this conflicting information that is coming to court, I think for us to draw a clear picture and even to place the prosecutor and the IO on what has been going on, maybe we can take a mention that where the complainant should attend court and we get clarity on how this matter will proceed. Because I received instructions from Mr. Kach in the morning. As far as I was concerned, Mr. Kach was with us in court the last time. And it tells me, I'm also aware that my client and the complainant had a meeting over the weekend convened by their uncle. These are family disputes. What interest will it be for me to insist when brothers are talking? If they can't agree, then let the justice system take this process. So my plea to the court at this point, in light of all this confusion, they go down and put the house in order. We also call the complainant whenever we come back. So there's clarity. Whatever clarification we need to be done, we have the complainant in court. He will give that clarification and information. So that if he is taking a plea, let him take a plea on that particular day. With full totality of all the facts. Because as it is, he may take plea today, and his presence in court doesn't deny taking plea. But then tomorrow we come before you, and we say, we've agreed as a family. Now we take out, we withdraw the entire charge. So an adjournment to clean the house causes no harm. The last time we were with you, the prosecutor was apprehensive that the accused was attempting to avoid attending court. It was not the case, it was because it was believed. And you can see, he is now in court responding to someone's case.
Thank you.
That is my proposal at this point.
With your kind permission, Your Honor, the representative of Mr. Okatch has confirmed they do not have instructions. The IO is in court, and the matter is supposed to be prosecuted by the state. So if the family is to withdraw, then the complainant will give instructions and come to withdraw. The matter first came to this court on the 24th, where the accused alleged he had been in contact with COVID patients. The matter further came on the 1st. The accused said he had lost the mother-in-law. So for the matter to come today and a further adjournment, I think it would be a way of wasting the court's time, because the accused is in court, the IO is in court, with the instructions for the matter to proceed.
What I hear from you, and which the court should promote, and the reasons that were given by the accused persons for previous non-attendance of court, I think those are issues that the court would honor. And I really want to go back and say, unless there is any mischief that has been established. So what I will do is that, in the spirit of promoting ADR, I'll give parties time, maybe up to 30. The prosecutor is in communication with the investigating officer, and the complainant is at liberty to talk to them, to the complainant, because as I've expressed, there seems to be no clear defined parameters regarding what is in and the prosecutor. There seems to be some sort of disconnect. So that whatever you do, as well as what you brief, then you address the prosecutor and brief the prosecutor at the other two. So if ADR doesn't then work, then the court will just have to But he's already told that this person is in court. You're not saying that this person has left.
Yeah.
So you give ADR a chance. If it doesn't work by Thursday, Friday, you proceed with it.
We stand guided, and we are not.